Hey everyone, in this video we are going to build a complete chat app with OpenAI GPT or any provider for that matter using Next.js and Vercel AI SDK in under 3 minutes. We will also take a look at the mind-blowing from Vercel, which generates UIs with ShedCN in React components. It's just all incredible, really. And I used the ShedCN, the V0, to actually build this. It works incredibly well, and it also can save conversations and then restart conversations. I'll be making a separate video on this, the more complex one. Today we'll just be building the simple one because I wanted to keep it simple. If you think you don't understand Next.js or you don't know it, please don't turn away, because I think Next.js is one of the significant future paths of building AI powered applications. I will actually try to convince you that you must at least take a look at it or give it a consideration. I also have created a video explaining how I entirely built this from scratch, the more complex version of the app, which is available at my 1000x Dev Masterclass. I already have 9 chapters here. I strongly recommend you check this out. This is available to my patrons, and the final project for the Next.js app is here available in 2 parts in this course, Masterclass. Based on my 3,000 hours of experience of creating AI-powered apps, I try to showcase my methods in using AI assistants and cursor on how to code fast and efficiently. Link will be in the description. So this is how our app works. It's a very simple app. You can just chat with the AI to your heart's content. And we are using Next.js. And I do want to say that when you create a Next.js project, which we will hear in a moment, you're going to see this complex structure of the project. But the only thing that we are worried about is what's underneath this app folder, pretty much, and especially the route.ts and the page.tsx. That's the only ones that we're going to be looking at. And that's really all you need for most cases. So let's start and build this from scratch. So let's start our project by initializing a Next.js project. I don't remember the command, so I'm going to come to terminal and click Control K and let cursor write this for me. I'm going to ask, please create a Next.js latest project named chat app. I do say latest, so we use the latest version of Next.js. So this is the command, create npx create dash next dash app at latest. And this is the name of our app. Let's go ahead and run this. And this is now starting our project, and then we're going to have to answer some questions. Would you like to use TypeScript? Yes, we're going to answer yes to this. TypeScript is just a much more strongly type-defined JavaScript. It's almost exactly the same thing, but it's very similar to using Pydantic with Python. We're going to say yes to this. Yes is what gives you those warning messages when there's something wrong, especially with types. We're going to say yes to Tailwind CSS. We're going to say no to src directory because we'll be using the app directory, but this is all entirely up to you. We're going to use app router, so we can use file-based routing. And we're going to say no to changing the import alias, and our app will be initialized. And you might get daunted by the amount of files that are created, but this package.json, for example, is kind of like requirements.txt. The only thing that we are concerned with right now is what is in the app under the app folder, and especially the page.tsx, which essentially has our homepage in it. JavaScript function, which is returning HTML and React components. So our project is initialized. Now we need to get into the chat under chat-app folder, and then we can run npm run dev, and this will start our server. I would like to take a moment to talk about the benefits of becoming a patron. As some of you may know, in the last year and a half, I've spent 3,000 hours over 3 projects. As a patron, you will have access to all the code files, so you can get inspiration and iterate quickly. Another benefit is that you'll have access to all my courses, and my most recent and most proud one, the 1000x Masterclass, teaching what I've learned on how to code fast and efficiently. Also the Streamlit course and the Fast API course. In my Patreon, I also have tiers in which you can connect with me one-on-one. Check those out as well. You don't need to start a separate backend server. You're going to be using the serverless abilities of Next.js, but once our server starts here in a moment, we'll be able to see this page.tsx displayed to us. Here we go. So this is what it looks like by default, but we can actually go ahead and delete all this stuff and just simply return hello, let's say, simply return a hello statement in h1 tags. And when we go back to our page, we see that hello world is created here. So this is really it. We're just going to be using the page.tsx, and we're going to create an API and use the AI SDK there. Next.js uses file-based routing, so you don't have to define your routes separately. For example, in Next.js, like in this app folder, I can create a new folder called one and create another page.tsx. And here we can return another statement, hello world. And then we go to this, then we add one to our URL and go, and we still see the hello world statement there. We can say hello to page one. And when we do that, we see that we are seeing hello to page one. So this is how we can create routes, okay? But we are not interested in this. So in this fashion, we can continue to build our API. I'm going to create an API folder. This is standard naming. And then I'm going to define the MS chat because that's what AI, Vercel AI SDK uses, normally speaking. And then route.ts file. So this is it. Our API endpoint is ready, but we do need to still install the AI SDK. Here it says you can install it with npm AI, but we do want to install the provider as well. So when we actually go to Next.js app router, we see that we can actually install the AI SDK with the OpenAI support. I'm not going to use PNP, but I'm just going to use npm. I'm going to copy this part. You can actually use the Zot as well. This is for generating structured data. We'll cover that in another video. I'm actually learning a lot of this stuff myself. So make sure that you are in your application folder and then install that command that we have copied, npm install all the way up to OpenAI. So now let's go ahead and do that. And when this is installed, it'll show up in your node modules, and under AI SDK, you can see we have OpenAI installed. After this point, all we have to do is, and you can also create a .env.local file and put your OpenAI API key, but if you have your environment variable set up, it should work just fine. Here, just create a route handler at the API chat route TS. All we have to do is copy this, and this is going to handle everything to make a call to GPT-4 Omni. Let's change the model. And it's going to handle streaming responses as well, even with a timeout. Next, all we have to do is actually copy this UI code from page.tsx and put it into our page.tsx, and that's it. And let's start back our dev server. If we actually look at this page.tsx, we see that it's very simple, 25 lines of code. One to display the AI and the user roles, and another just a form with an input. And now, here we go. We have our application ready, but when we got this from previously. Okay, so now it's ready, but when we type something, we don't get to see what we are typing because it's in color white. This is our input box, so we are dealing with Tailwind, so I'm just going to specify the text color to text gray 800, and the changes will be reflected automatically, and now I'm seeing what I'm typing. And now I can say hi in the AI response. This is GPT-4 Omni. This is it. And the roles are printed here conditionally. The messages we receive from the endpoint, this is what is being returned. And all of the rest of the stuff is taking care of it for us. I can actually select this in Control K and say, please make the, I can actually ask, please make the user and AI responses colorful and on opposite sides of the window. So the point I'm trying to make is that once you have something simple going like this, then you can actually easily modify it. There you go. We probably need to adjust the colors, but the fact that this works, as you can see, perfectly well. We can actually make these a little darker. Let's actually turn them to 600, and then that should make it. There we go. Tell me a joke. We just created a chat interface in under 3 minutes. If we were doing it without explaining, it would have been. And now you can actually expand upon this. And all we have used is the app folder. We didn't worry about any of the other stuff, which may have seemed complex. Now, so we use Next.js, very easy. You don't have to install Next.js. All you have to do is have Node installed on your computer. And now you just create applications. Sorry, you just initialize the Next.js application as we have done. And now you build your app under the app folder. And we are, of course, using the Vercel AI SDK. Do take a look at it. I think it's amazing. I'll be making more videos on it. And there's also the V0, which I have used to create the more complex version of this with conversation history. Let's just see how it works. So this creates React components for you using ChatCN UI library. It uses this automatically. Normally, you'd have to install components from this, but actually, let's ask for a simple, colorful chat UI. And actually, we are going to use speed. If you use quality, then the results are going to be better. But now we are just generating an entire UI component. You'll be able to, if we zoom out, you'll see it being built in real time. There's three examples with dummy text along with it, the code. Now here, we'll talk about that in a minute, but you can actually ask additional, you can give additional instructions and iterate over these. But I think to me, this is incredible. And this is actually done with the speed mode. And here is the code, the component.jsx, but as a matter of fact, all you have to do is just use this to install it. I have gone into details on how to do that in this project, in the 1000x masterclass. Do check it out. I do recommend this highly. And it's really has now quite a lot of chapters. Keep you going. This will be available at my Patreon along with the explanation video. And this project will be available at my Patreon for free if you want to download it. So this is it. I hope you enjoyed this. And I hope to see you in the next video. I would like to take a moment to talk about the benefits of becoming a patron. As some of you may know, in the last year and a half, I've spent 3,000 hours, over 300 projects as a patron. You will have access to all the code files so you can get inspiration and iterate quickly. Another benefit is that you'll have access to all my courses and my most recent and most proud one, the 1000x Masterclass, teaching what I've learned on how to code fast and efficiently. Also the Streamlit course and the Fast API course. In my Patreon, I also have tiers in which you can connect with me one-on-one. Check those out as well.